One day, as he's at the mouth and he's in there working that rock, he hears this loud noise like a trumpet. Dun, dun, dun. Well, he stops work. He looks off in the distance. He sees this cloud of dust coming towards him. And as he watches, he sees these huge elephants. They're war elephants. They kind of have the body armor. And on their back, these archers. I guess the gods heard his pleas, heard his wishes. And the next morning when he woke up, he was no longer a stonecutter. He had become the king. And here he was in this huge king-sized bed. Down by the river, the water's been evaporated. The fishing boats are all up on the bank. People have a worried look on their face. And he realizes something. And he gets selfish. He goes, why can't I have that kind of power? Well, the story moves on to where he becomes the sun. And sure enough, he sits there and he just devastates the earth with these huge heat waves, burning up crops, igniting forests. Man, he's living a good life, true power. So here he's in the middle of that plain. Nothing can touch him. The sun can beat down on him all day. He's not going to hurt me. The wind, the rain, that pushes and pulls, and he doesn't move. Even the king, when the king walks by, he has to go around the mountain. He's living a good life. It's all this little stone cutter with that pickaxe slowly chipping away. And each time that mountain realized something, that he wasn't quite as tough as he thought he was. Because that right there, that's true power. Why can't I be more like that guy? As a teacher, we use that little story for lots of different morals and lessons we teach. But what I think makes it appropriate for today is for all of you future teachers, please, never underestimate how much power you have. May not always feel like inspire students. You can motivate. You can offer your classroom into a safe haven for those kids that are struggling, the kids that are facing bullying issues, the kids that are suffering from different abuses. You have a chance to make relationships with students. You can become their role model. You can become the big brother or the big sister. You can be the one to help them through hard times. Pick them up when they fall, because we've all fallen. We've all had teachers who think that guy has power. It took me about 10 years to realize something. That true power is the stuff that we can do. My Uncle Randy, with as smart as he is, the secrets that he knows, the clearance that he gets, he can't do half the stuff that we can do. You have amazing powers. I wish you very well. I'm so proud of you. Good job. Good luck, teachers.